Governor General to deliver throne speech on November 19th. Finance Minister to present 2019 budget 2 days later. Details to this story and more coming up in the National Report. With the details to the news for today, Wednesday, October 24th, 2018, I am Wendy Edmond. Governor General Her Excellency Dame Cecile Lagrenade will prorogue Parliament days before she delivers the throne speech on November 19th. That announcement by Prime Minister Dr. The Right Honorable Keith Mitchell on Wednesday during the government's post-cabinet briefing. He said the throne speech is an outline of some of government's top priorities for the coming year while highlighting its major successes.
That, of course, will come after the proroguing of Parliament, which will be a few days before that. Normally, as you recall, each year we prorogue Parliament at least once, and then that to open it again, Parliament to function, we would have to reconvene it with a throne speech, and therefore that's the same thing. The reason this, and usually we have a few weeks or month or week or so in between the proroguing and the closing and the opening, but because of the national referendum on November 6th, we have no choice but to almost close and open almost simultaneously.
Dr. Mitchell also announced that the 2018-2019 national budget will be presented on Wednesday, 21st November. He said debates from both the upper and lower houses will immediately follow.
Debate will take place after that, so maybe most likely two, three days after that, depending on the time members take for us to do their presentation and reports and debates on that budget. And of course, there are other things that will come up. We're dealing with Christmas season almost on us.
The throne speech and the budget presentation will be held at the Grenada Houses of Parliament building at Mount Weldale. Grenada and other regional leaders have given a commitment to participate more in LIATS, but it must be a more structured and available airline. That was one of the decisions taken during a meeting of the heads in St. Vincent. Providing an update during the government's weekly post-cabinet briefing on Wednesday, Prime Minister Dr. The Right Honorable Keith Mitchell said the leaders all agree that the airline must be better run, providing more efficient and extended services to the region.
So Grenada's, like St. Lucia's, come as now indicated and agreed to participate more fully in LIAT, but a new revamped LIAT in the sense that the structure must change. LIAT must be able to increase its efficiency as it appears to be doing in the last few weeks or few months, not the historic one, and be able to become a profitable business.
Dr. Mitchell says while government will invest money in the airline, they will not seek to control its operations.
I'm against public sector running a private business. LIAT has to be a private business. Government may invest money and it gets money from shareholding profits when that operation makes profit, but not be involved in the management. Barbados, as Prime Minister Barbados, has taken the same position as Grenada. They are the majority shareholders right now, 49%. They say they will continue to invest, they'll continue to participate, but in a new LIAT atmosphere and a structure as far as LIAT's operation. Similarly, St. Lucia has made the same commitment.
This is the National Report. More news after the break.
Water up to my belly. Mattress floating, furniture floating, even the TV set floated for a while, you know.
My sneakers were floating just like boats.
Floods, they can happen so suddenly. What can you do?
Listen, when I saw the portable toilet from the construction site up the road float by and I realized that all that stuff was in the water.
Floods, hazards, take control, reduce your loss. What can you do to help stop flooding? Keep drains and wells clean and unblocked. Find out lots more about floods and other hazards at your local disaster office. A message from the National Disaster Management Agency and SIDERA.
Welcome back. After 5 years, the achievement of young people and the Ministry of Youth will be recognized during the week of November 9th to November 17th, 2018. The reintroduction of Youth Week 2018, according to Permanent Secretary Kevin Andal, is as a result of the efforts made to professionally develop the human resource capabilities within the ministry over the last 5 years. Mr. Andal was at the time addressing members of the media on Wednesday during the official launch of Youth Week 2018.
For the last 5 years, we looked at that last part of the youth policy, which is professionalization of the youth sector. So we focus a lot on developing all the structures, putting all the systems in place so that we can launch forward as we're doing now. So what you're seeing in recent time in terms of our programming is not by accident. It is by design. That now we are ready, now the systems are in place. The capacity of the and human resource within the division is fully energized to go forward. So it was strategic that we said that let us spend 5 years developing our systems. And we did that. So now it is a celebration.
Celebrating under the theme, Empowering Our Youth, Shaping Our Communities, and Protecting Our Future, the talents of the youth will be recognized. A major highlight of the week of activities is an awards ceremony carded for November 19th. Acting Youth Coordinator Norman Gilbert highlighted the process involved in the nomination of individuals for the awards.
We have some national awards, and we do have a process by which those persons would be selected. The areas highlighted where we have national organizations, we have written to those national organizations for nominations from these organizations for individuals for the various outstanding positions. Additionally, we have umbrella organizations that are specifically focused, for example, the RGPF, where we are going to be identifying a young officer, and the RGPF would assist or support in terms of making that nomination as the best possibly placed organization or entity to do so. We also have areas where we internally would have to make some decisions in terms of the entities that support youth development work, the stakeholders that support youth development work. We are quite aware of those entities that have supported our work for the last 5 years, and we believe that we are in a good position to make those nominations. So we are going to be inviting nominations from general public, from national entities, and we have a period by which these entities should submit the nominations, and the deadline for submission is the 9th of November.
The general public and the national entities are invited to nominate outstanding youth in various aspects for selection. Youth Week 2018 will be opened with an official address by Honorable Kate Lewis, Minister with Responsibility for Youth Development. Other activities to commemorate the week include a fitness revolution, peace concert, prison outreach, National Youth Expo, and Youth Service Weekend. Meanwhile, in Karakumpiti, Martinique, some of the activities include National Youth Parliament, National Church Service, and graduation of Batch 4 Imani trainees, and the National Youth Concerts. Finally, in the news, the St. Patrick Arcy School is receiving assistance from the New York-based X Students Association to outfit its computer lab with AC units. On Tuesday, the Association Vice President Sean Baldio presented check to the school valued at over $60,000.
I would like to start off by handing over a check to the principal of the St. Patrick's IRC School on behalf of the Ex-Student Association. It's a check for $6,400 to cover the two cooling units that's been damaged. So, Mr. Principal, this is from Excellence Association.
Parliamentary Representative for St. Patrick West, Honorable Anthony Bostwin, commended the association for its significant contribution to the development of the school and the parish.
And therefore, I really want to place on record my appreciation and the appreciation of the government for the significant contribution that your institution has been making to the school. It reflects not only the patriotism of the members of your group, but also it reflects that critical role that you are playing, because if you have not been doing what you have been doing, it means that the government had to take over that task. So in essence, you are helping the government. Because can you imagine a school without a computer lab? Because as it is today, a computer lab, in my opinion, is an essential prerequisite for every school in Grenada.
Principal Rodney Julian expressed gratitude to the members of the association on behalf of the school. The St. Patrick's Ex-Students Association New York in the past also donated 30 tablets to the school, which is currently a part of the school's media center. And that's a wrap on the National Report for today, Wednesday, October 24th, 2018. On behalf of all of us in the newsroom, I am Wendy Edmond, thanking you for viewing.